frightened. "Look!" he cried. Jip looked. On a little island out in the middle of the lake stood a great big oak tree. Weighted down the acorns on every side. Down the shore, the chipmunks ran. But brrr, it was too cold to swim. "How can we get to them?" wondered Jip. "I don't know," said Dale. But he soon had an idea. "Look in there," he said. On the mantel in Donald Duck's cottage, they could see the toy sailboat. "Come on," said Dale. So away they raced and straight into the cottage door. They had the sailboat down and almost out the door when Donald stirred in his sleep. "Nice day for a sail," he said dreamily, as the boat slipped smoothly past his eyes. Soon after, Donald wake up completely. "Now to try out my boat," he cried. Suddenly, something outside the window caught his eyes. It was his sailboat out on the lake. "I'll fix those chipmunks," Donald said. He pulled out his fishing rod and reel and chased a painted fly. "It looks just like a nut." "This will do," Donald grinned. From the pier, he cast as far as he could. Fling that little fishing fly. With a plop, it landed beside the toy boat. "Look! Look at this!" cried Dale. He leaned way over the edge of the boat to pull in the floating fly. "Good! A nut!" said Chip. "We'll toss it in the hold and have it for supper tonight." As soon as it was fast in the hold, Donald pulled in the line. He pulled that little boat right in the shore. The chipmunks never suspected a thing. They did not even notice Donald pouring water into the cabin of the boat. Chip discovered that when he went into the cabin, "Man, the pumps!" he cried. Those two chipmunks worked with might and main, while Donald watched and laughed. "It's a trash baby. Trash baby." "Where are we?" "Ha ha ha!" Donald's chuckle. The chips look up. "So that's the trouble," they cried. He pulled out a fishing fly from the hold and flung it at Donald's dad so that he was soon tangled up in a fishing line. While Donald tried to tug himself free, the chips set sail once more. Before Donald could launch his swift canoe, they had touched at the island shore. As Donald was paddling briskly along, he heard a breeze rat-tat-tat-tat. The oak tree on the island seemed to shiver and shake as its shore of acorn rained down. The busy little chipmunks finished dancing on the branches. Then they hauled their habits aboard. "Oh well," said Donald, watching from his canoe. "At least I know the sailboats really will sail. Now let's just see what those little fellows do." And you can guess what the chipmunks did. They stored their nuts in a hollow tree and did Donald's toy sailboat right back and put it where it belonged. Okay. Fastest dog in the West. Name is Benji. Okay. As soon as Cindy opened the back door, Benji and Tiffany scampered outside. "Paul," Cindy called. "It's time for the morning sweetie pie chase." "What, you angry?" Sweetie Pity was sunning herself on Mrs. Finster's fins, waiting for them as usual. Benji and Tiffany. Okay.